It's about a 3,000 foot drop to the valley there. You can see a village right in the bottom of the valley. Stunning. So there you go, guys. Simeon Mountains. Pretty impressive, hey? Possibly the best view I've had so far. The sun's blazing down off this escarpment over the Ethiopian Highlands. What a sight. Amazing. I'm just so glad there's a little glimmer of sun after the rain last night. So there you have it. Ethiopia at its best. I'm just totally blown away by the scenery here. It's amazing. I've just seen the baboons and the landscape in which they live is this. It's stunning. You've got a hell of a drop off the top there. We're on an escarpment, but it's got to be 3,000-4,000 foot down into the valley there. This ledge where I'm on now literally just drops away 3,000 feet. Good place for hang gliding. Incredible, look how close I've managed to get, and they're just not bothered about me. Look at that big one. He must be the leader of the pack. Wow, there's like 100 here. Look at the little babies. Oh my god, they're so cute. Check this out. Not necessarily the view, but check out the falls. They are absolutely enormous. I'd say you're looking at 2,000 feet there. That's a rival to Angel Falls in Venezuela. It must be Ethiopia and Africa's highest falls. It's a single drop, a couple of thousand feet. My camera can barely fit it all in. How's that for size? What a gorge. Breathtaking stuff. Absolutely unbelievable. So funny. It's like the sandpit playtime. Oh wow. They just fly off the edge. There's like a climbing wall for some of them where they're hanging on and falling down. Just having a lunch break, the second lunch break. There's four Ferengis foreigners across there, and fair play, miserable ass. Only one of them actually bothered to say hello. Which you think when you come all the way out here, why are people like that? And I'd say the Ethiopians have been really friendly. I've got wet hair because I've just given myself a wash in the stream, which is nice and refreshing. Time for a bit of bread. It's good stuff. Mmm. Still pretty fresh too. Unfortunately, we have a large climb up over that hill next, so better make sure I've got the energy. Oh, cute. Run to mummy. Oh. There's some little village kids here tending to their flock. This really is out in the wilds. I think there's a lot of soil erosion going on around here. Maybe the land's been over-farmed because the hillside opposite there is very, very black-looking soil. There's nothing binding it together, whereas the one to the left is full of trees and it's a bit more intact up the top there. Hello, Mr. Sheep. Hiya. You're on camera. I'm not understand what you're saying, sorry. I am in bits. I'm in such agony. I hit the wall back there at Geech Village. Don't quote me, but I think that house on the top there is the campsite I'm staying at tonight. God, I hope so. I've got absolutely nothing left in me. I've basically done a 600 meter, which is almost 2,000 foot climb just now, up from the valley where the waterfall was to where I am now. It's quite a campsite here at Geech. It's my lonely tent. cloud base is up, no rain as well, which is good. I don't care once I climb in that tent. It's quite a little gathering here. I don't think I've been this grateful arriving in a place in years, on foot that is. It's just been one hell of an afternoon. The morning was good, but the afternoon was a killer. Asmaro's checking the rice out now. He's seeing if it's good to eat. He's testing it out. It's good, yeah? Okay, yeah. We've got some garlic in there as well. So it's feeding time. It's taking a while to boil because we're at 12,000 feet. It's a merry bunch here. It's all the scouts and all the porters together. There's my lonely little tent. I'll be in later on. Flapping away in the breeze. It's definitely a bleak camp up here. There's the cooking hut. It's just the fire hut. It's where the Farangis hang out. I think there's a mix of nationalities here today. Oh. Hello. Alright. God, it's so cold. Where are you all from? France, Germany, everywhere, yeah?
Four French,
three German, yeah, and one from England. Yeah, hi.
From Ethiopia.
Ah, yeah. Ethiopia.
She's
yeah.
Also from Ethiopia.
Oh, yeah. You live here. The sun has got his hat on. Fantastic. It's just me and Asmara, my scout, alone heading up to Imetgogo, which is 4,000 meters. We're traveling light. We've left a load of gear back at Geech, which we'll pick up later before we head back to Sankabert. In the words of my good friend from New Zealand, John Orwin, this is UFB. I'll let you work that out for yourself. Wow. It's like a Grand Canyon of Ethiopia. It certainly rivals it for my liking. Really, pictures can't do it justice. But what you're looking at there is one incredible geographical feature, or many. It's Ethiopian highlands have been pushed up millions of years ago. There was a lot of volcanic activity here. And now erosion has taken over the formation of all these, like, butts and mesas. They're almost like the American Southwest. Amazing. Asma's taken us on a little detour, but it's definitely worth it. Check this one out. Beautiful. There's a real drop to a gorge down there. You can just see right in the valley. Wow. That was worth the extra 10 minutes. You can see where we were earlier, actually. It was on the right-hand side of the ridge. The highermost point on the view.
So much better. I've not had a shower in about 3 days now, so a stream is all I have to get clean. It does the job though, yes.
Imetgogo, it's a long way off now. It's probably about 15 k's. Well, 12 perhaps. Where we're heading, well, first of all, we've got this gorgeous view, which was cloudy yesterday and rainy, but I can see more of it today. And then the way we're heading is the Saint Cabert Road down there. There's my tent and there's the baboons. Yep, we have baboons on the campsite. Little scavengers. Cute. Look at the little furry heads. Okay, I'm just having a beer with three graduates from University of Michigan who are experts in primates. So, look at this weather, crazy. Bit of hailstone for you.
Whoops!
Alright.
These shoes are disgusting.
It's already starting to look greener from last week. It's amazing. How quick does grass, like, starting to grow?
Is the kind of the wet season starting a little earlier? Because some people are saying that.
Well, there's supposed to be, like, a mini rainy season in April.
Yeah.
Which, the first week of March, no, first, second week of March, we just had a week of solid fog roll over.
Oh, really?
We thought that was it, but it's starting to get rainy, and I don't know if it's...